As demand for online shopping continues to soar, NZ Post's unveiled a massive multi-million dollar parcel processing centre, a bid to future-proof the company. But the Postal Workers Union says staff are being left out of that future, and it's taking legal action to try to save jobs. Simon Merced reports.
It's the size of four rugby fields. This South Auckland warehouse will handle a lot of parcels, more than double the current amount.
We expect New Zealanders to continue to buy online, and that is why we're growing and investing in this sort of capacity.
A barcode reader identifies parcels, they're then sorted to send around the country.
It provides more efficiency, more accuracy and better reading of the addresses and the barcodes to enable things to get to the destination.
In July, an international gateway will be added, with border staff on site to process overseas packages. It's all part of a $200 million upgrade by NZ Post. But unions say that upgrade also means hundreds of posties will lose their jobs to be replaced by contractors.
We're only at the beginning now of this campaign to save the jobs of posties and to stop a state-owned enterprise going down the path of contractualising work.
The union's just gone to the Employment Relations Authority to try and force the company back into collective bargaining over job cuts. And then in July, it's in court seeking to have two contractors declared as employees. Management would not comment on the legal action, but said this about job losses.
Most importantly, we have to help our people through that change well.
It's a package of change unions will still fight as one Kiwi business adapts to new technology and shifting consumer demand. Simon Mercep, One News.